So welcome, everybody. The next presentation will be about a small open source project, which is mainly for land surveyors, but it may be fill the gap between the land surveyors' data sources and the GIS data sources. Let me first introduce myself. I work for the Budapest University of Technology. I forget to mention you that this is the logo of our faculty for civil engineering. We are the academic partner of the Phosphor-G Bucharest, and we have an OSGEO lab, which is, this is the logo of our OSGEO lab. Maybe you have find some stickers without this, because OSGEO use our logo as we gave them, but of course then you may have one sticker on your laptop, or you can may ask Astrid Emde to send you such a sticker. Okay, so, sorry. About me, I am an open source GIS user, teacher, advocate from the very beginning, and I make some localization of software. The biggest work was the QGIS Hungarian translation. Nowadays, the OSGEO Live is 95% translated to Hungarian. I took part in several Phosphor-G Europe conferences. This is the my first world conference. I am partly QGIS plugin developer. I am a charter member of OSGEO. We have this OSGEO lab, and for this conference I was the committee member of the general track. So, about GeoEasy, this software is very old, but in the open source market, or not market, in the open source world, it started 2 years ago. First, it was developed for a small enterprise, internal use. Then we realized that it can be useful for others. We start to make a proprietary software from it. And 2 years ago, we have changed the license to open source. It is written in TQL-TK. Who knows what is TQL-TK? There may be some GRASS users who remember that the previous GUI of GRASS was written in TQL-TK. If somebody use TK intern in Python, then he or she use this TK also.
It was used a lot in IRC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nowadays, it's available in 5 languages, and of course, it's open for anybody to translate his language. We have some binary releases for Debian, Ubuntu, and for Windows. And the source code is available on the GitHub. This is the GitHub page of the project. You can see we have few contributors, so it's not a we have not a big community to build this software. The first aim of this presentation to make wider this community. We have regular releases, usually 2 releases in a year. I suppose it's nearly 400 commits in 2 years. It's quite big. Sometimes it's very small change in a commit. Sometimes it's it's a bigger one. Okay, what is it? Sorry? What is this GeoEasy for? When we start this program, the first aim was to make some special surveying calculation, which is something coordinate geometry to calculate the intersection of two lines, two arcs, but only in the plan, as the surveyors works, not on the geoid or on the sphere at all. It means that, we have some input, we have instruments with some angles, distance, or coordinates, or keyboard input even, or GPS receiver, and add the data together, and we use the specific calculation method of land surveyors. Are there here land surveyors? Yes, quite good. So I can say traversing, resection, and even network adjustment is involved in 1, 2, and 3 dimension. This is the result, for example, of a land surveyor with error ellipses. But for the adjustment, an external program, GNU GaMa, is used, which is developed at the Technical University of Prague. So we use that. This is some part of the graphic display of the software. And of course, these data can be transferred to several formats, LibreOffice for documentation purposes, for GIS some data, for CAD system. To tell you the truth, the land surveyors prefer CAD to create the maps because they don't care about attributes, or rarely care about attributes. Sorry? The other branch in the software, bless you, is the digital terrain models. We use thin models and grid models. For generating the thin model, we use again another open source software called Triangle. It's a small library written in C, C++, and we can generate grid files to send it to any GIS software in ascii ascii grid format, or even grass ascii grid format. This is how we can see in our software this thin. Here, these blue lines are the so-called break lines, which are important if you would like to create a reliable model. And this is, it's not very good resolution. The same DTM in QGIS 3D view. And this is also in QGIS 3D view. Our software has no 3D viewer at all, not yet. You may be added to this. Sorry, there is a third branch of things in the software, which is called regression calculation. To tell you the truth, it's not too near to GIS. It means we have some points and we would like to find the best fitting line, curve, sphere, or plan, or something like that. It is how it works. We have some points. Let's find the circle where the distance of the points from the circle, the sum of the squares of this distance is minimal. Then we can have, it's usually we have only alphanumerical feedback about the calculation. And for example, here are the differences in radius direction from the circle. Sometimes we have to measure cubes, and it's useful that case to find the radius and so on. The fourth chapter I would like to mention you is that we have various export-import formats. Here, for example, in the land surveying for the instruments, there are no real standards. All the instrument producers create a new format, or maybe the same producer has several formats in the time. So it's sometimes a nightmare for a land surveyor if he has several instruments, or if he or she gets some data from other sources and he have to do something with it. So this is the so-called input-output formats what are handled. We have, there is no enough place to list all of them. We have more than 10 total station formats from Leica to Topcon to Shokia and so on. So for several formats, of course, not all what we meet so far. We can get data from some other land surveying software. We have textual input. We can get transformation parameters from the file, and even we can communicate the instrument with the serial line to get or send data between the surveyor's instrument. All these data formats are ASCII format and open format, so anybody can have information about the how the data are organized in these formats. For input and output, we use also CAD format, DXF, and as I mentioned previously, we can use the ASCII grid formats of GRASS or ASRI. And for output, we have several different formats, some of them useful for GIS purposes. For example, here CSV, GPX, KML can be imported or used in QGIS or maybe any GIS software. So this is why I have the observations. I made the calculation and I can export to some format which importable to other GIS software. The fifth point here is from the 3.1 version, we have a console inside the software, and the app API is also open and is documented. This API documentation is generated from the source, and it's available. I will show you the URL where you can read this. And with this console, you can use this to type in any tickle command and to use the whole functionality of this software. It's very similar to when you have a Python prompt and you can directly input Python code, Python commands, and try it. It means that we have the TCL console. Here you can give any command and you get some result. For example, here it is in degree, and I changed that degree to degree minutes seconds for a small example. But it's not only useful for this. Here I can load a file, and for example, here is a function. You can see this is a TCK code, and it is loaded because it's a function, it's not executed, it's only stored, and then I can use this function. For example, it's useful to change XY coordinates. Sometimes we have problem the order of coordinates, so this is a useful function to change the horizontal coordinates. Sorry. So we think that it's no sense to write twice the same software. So that's why if we find an open source product which solve the problem, we will use it. So we have a long list of different projects which results are used. First of all, the TickleTK. Unfortunately, it's less and less popular. Later I can speak about something TickleTK or Python. We use GNU GaMa, which is written in C++ and used for 1-3-dimensional network adjustment. For the land surveyors, I have to mention that GNU GaMa has some functionality to eliminate blunders, larger errors. And GNU GaMa has no official user, graphical user interface. This is a CLI program, and the input is an XML document. So it's very hard for a land surveyor to write an XML document from their observations. So this program can solve the conversion between the usual surveyor's format and this format which is necessary for GNU GaMa adjustment. I mentioned we use Triangle for the thin networks. We use somewhere PROJ because when we export to KML or GPX, then we can use this PROJ. ANSYS is used to generate the Windows binary setup kit. It's a nullsoft installation kit. FreeWrap is used to change TickleTK code to an executable Windows code. Bash DebBuild is used to create the Debian package from the software. TCL doc is used to generate the API documentation. RST to PDF is used to generate the documentation from RST is restructured text. Am I right? Something this. Okay. Is used. The documentation is written in this. It's very similar to Markdown. Maybe a bit more complicated. But for example, GitHub supports, so the RST documentation are displayed by GitHub quite good. And we use PNG quant to reduce the size of the images which are involved in the documentation. here are the most important links about the software. On this page you can find the binary releases. Sometimes we make a nightly build version which contains all the actual development. We have a documentation. Unfortunately, the reference guide is not ready. it has been started. For the documentation, we have a full installation guide for Linux and for Windows. We have a so-called step-by-step guide for something like a user guide. All the functionality is not mentioned there, but some basic things are shown, and we have some demo data set which is used here, so when you install the software, you install some data to be able to try something. We have a wiki about 12 entry point in this wiki, and the source code is available on GitHub. We have this API documentation available on the internet also, and of course we have also an issue tracker on GitHub. What is important to mention, we would like to have some helping hand to write the documentation. If somebody is ready to do that, it's usually for open source projects, it's the most difficult part. The developer cannot write the documentation which is useful for the everyday user. Sometimes they try to put down what is some computational problem instead of the usage. So it's difficult to find or people to write the documentation. But of course, beside this, we welcome any helping hand, bug reporting, testing, bug reporting, and even coding. Coders are welcome too. I hope so. At least one of you will help us in the near future. Okay. As I mentioned you, we work in a we have a Geo for All lab, and we have some other projects. This is I mentioned something about Python. We have a surveying calculation plugin for QGIS, which is rewritten of GeoEasy in Python. But unfortunately, it is now only available for QGIS 2. It was not upgraded to QGIS 3. About or nearly 10,000 downloads are of this module on the official QGIS plugin page. We have an other project which called Ulysses. It's only for surveyors to make automation observations with robotic total stations. And some other sensors are used. I have spoken about that in Como in 2015 at the European conference. And on the OSGeo Labs GitHub page, you can find some tutorials. Some are in English, some are unfortunately in Hungarian. Okay. So at the end of the presentation, during the evolution, the humankind reached, for me so far, the highest level to be a land surveyor. I don't know what will be the next. Okay, so thank you for your attention, and join our project if you can do it. Thank you. Questions? Okay.
Maybe I lost something, but I will ask you on which kind of device or how you go in the field with this software.
This software is for post-processing. So you may go outside with your instrument, collect the data, and then post-process. Most of the instruments are able to calculate the coordinates. But some cases, when, for example, you need network adjustment, it's not used, the instruments are not prepared for that. Or you have several instruments, collected the data, and put them together. So some calculations can be done on board, on field, on the instrument, and you can make it in the office on this software. Of course, you can go out with a laptop, but it's no sense. Next one.
Is the software GUI only, or does it have a CLI interface?
The software GUI only, but you have the API.
Okay, but you still have to load the GUI.
Yeah. It's your own task to make the CLI commands what you need. Maybe you have to be careful which function use GUI functions and which functions does not use GUI function. To tell you the truth, when we write this surveying calculation module for QGIS, we were separating clearly what is GUI, what is calculation. But in GeoEasy, from the beginning, more than 20 years ago, I am not sure it's clearly separated everywhere. Or we need more work to do it, or at least check it. Sorry.
I wanted to ask if the formats for the instruments, can we write ourselves if we have instruments in certain format? Okay, that was one question. For the TIN, you show us you can use break lines. I wanted to ask if you can define the break lines in the software, or you have to have the break lines prepared, like from point to point to point, and upload them in the software. And that's it.
Okay. For the first question about the formats, the software has a general format, which we call the dump format. When you have records, and you can define when you input which column is for what. But it's not a format created by any instrument. It's usually we use it to communicate with different software. The formats of the instruments are so. Has so many variations, we cannot make a general thing to only define something. So each new total station format is written. The second question about the brake lines, you have two chances. The first chance is that you draw the lines in the software. The other chance is that if you have the brake lines in DXF, it can be imported.
The network calculations, can you mix observation from GPS instruments or hand-measured thing in your network?
Not really. The GNU GaMa software has two sub-projects. One is the so-called GaMa local, to work in a Cartesian system and no GPS supported, or we sometimes make that from GPS observations, we calculate azimuths and distances, what we can adjust it by this software. But it's not useful for GPS observation adjustment.
Have you applied this software during some teaching courses? And what is your opinion if it can be used during teaching activities, during workshops?
As I am a teacher at the university, this software is used at the very beginning in teaching. And one thing to change it to open source to help the students to use it. Before, there was a limited license free for limited time for the students to make their homework. Now it's not a problem because it's open source. So thank you, and it's time for the next presentation.